Hello friends, you are watching Android Tech Solutions, and today in this video we are going to configure Team with broadcast configuration. So now let us start. So for configuring Team, we must have more than one NIC. Okay, so I'll check it by running this command ifconfig. So over here I have only one NIC. Okay, and this is the loopback and this is the virtual machine. We'll not use this. So we have only one NIC. So for configuring Team, we must have more than one NIC. So I'm working in a virtual machine. So I can add virtual NICs. So I'll just go to the virtual machine manager and just turn off the virtual machine. And now I will just click on virtual machine details. And here you have to click on show virtual machine details. And here you can see you have only one NIC, which is this one. Now just click on add hardware. From here you just choose the third option, which is network. Over here you have to choose the network source. You can choose any. I'm using the bridge because I've created bridge in my physical machine. Okay, you can choose anyone. Okay, so now we have two NICs. I'll create one more NIC. Okay, now I'll just start this virtual machine. SSH my virtual machine. Okay, now I'll run that command again. So over here we have two more NICs. We have created virtual NICs using the virtual machine. Okay, so here now we have two more NICs. Okay, now what we will do is we will create a team. So the command is nmcli connection add, then you have to give the connection name. The connection name I am giving it as team. You can give any connection name as any connection name as anything. Okay, then you have to give type. Type is team. Okay, here you have to only give team. Then you have to give interface name. Interface name will be team. Then you have to give configuration. So I'll just press enter and it is showing error that you have not given any configuration. So I'll just open a man page. I'll show you this. This man page will be helpful for you also. So here are all the types of team configuration: broadcast, round robin. You can just refer these, and we'll just go at the last. Here we have the examples. So here are the examples. So here we are going to create the broadcast one. So I'll just search for the broadcast. So I'll just choose this one, active backup, and we'll just rename it as load balancer. Oh, sorry, broadcast. Okay, I'll just save it over, paste it over here. And we instead of active backup, we'll write here broadcast. And after config, you have to give a space, then you have to give a open curly bracket, and before that you have to give a single quote. And after this broadcast, you have to close the curly bracket and give a single quote. So here you can see a connection team successfully added. Now you have to run a command nmcli connection show. So here you can see a team has been configured successfully. Okay, now this is the master. Now we have to create slaves using our NIC cards. Okay, now we'll run the command nmcli connection add connection name, and the connection name we will give at as team slave. You can give any name. I'm giving team slave one. Then you have to give the type. The type is team dash slave. Okay, you have to give this type only, means the team dash slave. Then you have to give the interface name. So over here, the interface name will be ENS10 or ENS11. The name of this interface might be different at yours. Okay, now I'm giving ENS10. Okay, then you have to give connection dot auto connect. Yes. One more thing you have to specify after this interface name is master, which I forgot to give. And you have to give master as the team name. So the team name is team. Okay. Now press enter. So now here you can see we have configured team slave one successfully. So here the mistake which I did was I didn't specify master. So you have to specify the master. Okay. Connection show. So here you can see team slave has been created successfully. Okay. Now similarly we'll create a team slave 2 with the help of ENS11, the LAN card. And the master is team. Okay, now I'll run that command again. So here you can see team slave 2 has been configured successfully. Now I'll run a command to check team CTL. Then you have to give the team name, and now you have to give the state, STATE. So here you can see we have created a team with the configuration of broadcast, and we have this the NIC is working also, means the slave. This is the team, and these both are the slaves. Okay. So now I will just give an IP to our team. So I'll give NMCLI connection modify. Connection modify on the team name team, and then IPv4 address I'll give. You can give any IP, and then you have to give the net mask. Connection modify. Okay, then we have to give a method. It is compulsory to give the method. I'm giving manual, and then you will give connection dot auto connect equals to space. Yes. Now I'll just MCLI connection up team. Okay, the connection has activated successfully. Now we'll run a command if config. Now you can see the team has been configured successfully using, and these are both are the slaves. Okay, the team has been configured successfully. Now I'll just try to ping the team to check the connection whether it is working fine or not. So here you can see we are getting ping also. So that's it guys, we have just configured our team with the broadcast configuration. Thank you guys for watching this video. Do like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel.